Welcome back, everyone. A look at my knee right here. We're going to be talking about iOS 13.5 on the iPhone 8 Plus. Now, it's going to randomly be getting brighter and darker because the sun is so weird, but this update was a pretty big update in my opinion. It honestly brought a lot of things to the table, and it's not like the craziest update ever made, but I think for a 0.x release, it's actually pretty important, and it has a lot to do with the current situation that we're in. As you all know, we're inside and everything, and one of the biggest updates that came with this specific update was the exposure notifications API. And for those of you who don't know, Google and Apple actually combined forces to make it so whenever there's any updates or notifications or whatever for the whole COVID-19 situation, Apple and Google created this API for them to send notifications out to our iPhones. And with this new iOS update, it actually brings that kind of capability, which is really cool. So I think that in and of itself is a pretty big reason to go and update specifically to iOS 13.5. You shouldn't be worried about losing your jailbreak or anything, because with that checkering jailbreak, you can obviously jailbreak back, and I should have a tutorial later on this channel on how to do that. Another cool update actually came with Face ID and passcode unlocking. So as you guys know, well, first of all, this phone doesn't have Face ID, but for those of you who do have an iPhone 11 Pro or whatever the case is, if you unlock your phone and get into Face ID, basically it's kind of an annoying process. You have to wait for Face ID to fail, and then you have to type in the passcode after. But now with iOS 13.5, they eliminated that little lag in the little waiting period for the Face ID to fail. So now the passcode just comes up immediately, which is really cool, and I'm actually really happy they did that. That was a really annoying thing. I had to constantly wait for Face ID to fail, but now we don't have to do that anymore, which is really cool. Now, I didn't get the size of this update, but for most of my updates, it was about 400 to 300 something megabytes, so make sure you have a little bit of storage saved. And another thing, basically all my updates, I've saved storage when I updated, which was really cool. So if you're updating your phone, best believe you're probably going to end up saving some storage. Now, another cool thing is within FaceTime. Now, obviously, I don't have it enabled on here, but basically, if you guys know with group FaceTime, if you ever went ahead and group FaceTime to people, they would constantly just go up and down, like the squares would get bigger and smaller based on whoever was talking. And now with iOS 13.5, that is eliminated. I think you have the option to take that off, which is so cool. And I'm so happy Apple did that. So that was one thing that would really annoy me. But now with this update, that actually went away. And another specific problem that a lot of people had was within Safari. And basically, if anybody ever played a video or anything like that, sometimes it wouldn't even play the video. It would just be like some black box thing. But now Apple went ahead and fixed that too. So this update was really just a big bug fix update in its core. It fixed a lot of things that were kind of problematic with iOS 13.4.1. And I'm really happy they pushed this one out. So if you have an iPhone 8 Plus, I would recommend updating. It didn't crash my phone. No crazy things like that. It was very stable. And I think if you own an iPhone 8 Plus or whatever, I would highly recommend you guys to update your phone. So that's really pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those things are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys would check it out. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.